Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 22, featuring Lucille Ball, Jim Backus, Jack Benny, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
Box 13, with the star of Paramount Pictures, Alan Ladd, as Dan Holliday.
Dear Dan, I'm inviting you up to Fair Oaks to spend the last weekend with me. Forget your Box 13 gag for a while and grab yourself a little vacation. There's not much I can offer in the way of excitement or adventure. But if you'll really go any place or do anything, you might like to see the crumbling grandeur of the last weekend.
Crumbling grandeur of the last of the Kenwers. You know how to get there, and I'll be waiting. How about it? Ted. Vacation, the man said. You know, someday I'm really going to take a vacation. But this wasn't it.
Back to Box 13 and Dan Holliday's newest adventure, Last Will and Nursery Rhyme.
I think you should go, Mr. Holliday. You need a rest.
Oh, Susie, every time I go for a rest, something happens to me.
But what can happen at a nice, quiet place like Fair Oaks? Gee, from what your friend Ted says about it, it's just the spot to take it easy.
You sure of that, huh?
Uh-huh. Why, you'll come back all full of vim and vinegar.
Okay, Susie, you talk me into it. Forward my mail to Fair Oaks, care of Ted Kenworth. It was pleasant, a 200-mile drive through the countryside. I was forgetting all about Box 13. It chased after me all the way up to Fair Oaks. I got there in the evening, and Ted was waiting for me. Maybe I should explain Ted and Fair Oaks. You see, Ted was my closest friend at college, and, well, he had inherited Fair Oaks. One of those big, overdone houses people were fond of building in the 1890s. It looked like an insane wedding cake. Gingerbread balconies, all running around and contributing nothing to the architectural value of the place. Anyway, I parked on the drive, walked up the stairs with Ted and into the house.
Oh, I'm glad you came, Dan. I've been wanting to have you up here for a long time, but guess I never got around to it.
Hey, what do you do for space here? Suppose you have a house full of guests and you've only got 20 rooms.
Yeah. Well, don't worry. I won't have it long.
What do you mean?
Come on in here. It's the only room with chairs.
Hey, why the crepe hanging?
Oh, I'm selling, Dan.
Selling? Oh, but you're kidding.
No, I wish I was kidding, but can't keep this place up.
You're broke?
Flatter than last week's pancakes.
Oh, but I thought you inherited a
money
lot of money.
From Uncle Thaddeus? No. Not a thin, round dime.
Oh, now, wait a minute. He had $1,000 for every breath he took.
Did he?
I'm asking.
I'm telling. No, Dan. All he left me was this house.
Are you sure?
There we go again. Look, fella, I've been asked that question a million times. All he left was the house.
That doesn't seem right. Wasn't he a millionaire?
Uh-huh.
Then where's his money?
Gone. Finished. Kaput.
But look, where could a guy like your Uncle Thaddeus spend all of his money?
That's the gold-plated question. He never spent a nickel if he could help it.
Okay, then the money's still with us.
Dan, you kill me. You're so tied up with fiction that you look for a deep, dark plot in everything.
Yeah, but this makes no sense.
It does when you check and find out that Uncle Thaddeus lived the last 5 years on credit.
Credit? You mean with all of his dough?
Ah, that's right.
Well, there must be a record of the money.
I had help looking for it.
Help? Who?
Uncle Sam. Oh. Income tax, inheritance tax. If they couldn't find the dough, how could I? No, Dan. Uncle Thaddeus fooled everybody. He didn't have a nickel.
Well, it sounded offbeat to me. Uncle Thaddeus lived close to his vest. And he had had money at one time, lots of it. He never went anyplace, did anything. But a cool $3 million or so just curls up and evaporates. Or did it? Anyway, I thought about it later that night.
Oh, why don't you stop, Dan? You're supposed to take a vacation, and you're beating your brains out.
Now, listen. Put it together, and what have you got? Uncle Thaddeus, practically a hermit. He's known to have money, but when he dies, all he leaves is this, well, this oversized lean-to.
Dan, I've looked through the whole house. I know it like the back of my hand. I lived here when I was a kid after Mother and Dad died.
What about the will?
Uncle's?
Yeah.
Well, nothing about money in it.
Oh, excuse me, Ted.
Oh, it's okay. Come on in, Helen.
Well, I didn't knock or ring the bell. I didn't know you had company.
Oh, it's all right. Helen, this is Dan Holliday. Dan, this is Helen Stark.
How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Helen's clearing out odds and ends for me, Dan.
Odds and ends?
Well, I was Thaddeus Kenworth's secretary. That is, once in a while I was. When he got behind in cataloging books, I came in and did it for him.
Oh.
Sit down, Helen. Join the wake.
Well, I haven't much time. I want to sort out some papers. You can look them over tomorrow, Ted.
I don't want to. Throw them out.
What papers?
Mr. Kenworth kept everything.
Yeah, he collected bills, receipts, pieces of twine, bits of paper.
Oh, he wasn't that bad.
Okay, just like to keep things.
Including money.
Yeah.
What do you mean, Mr. Holliday?
Where's his money?
Well, he didn't leave any.
That's what the man said.
But he didn't, did he, Ted?
No.
Then where is it?
Helen, let me explain. You see, Mr. Holliday has a complex. To him, the simple act of taking a drink of water is filled with mystery and dark meaning.
You want to borrow my cloak and dagger?
Well, you two argue about it. I'll be all finished tomorrow, Ted. You can look over everything. See you later, Mr. Holliday.
Oh, good.
Nice girl.
Uh-huh.
What's the matter? Don't you like her?
I just met her. What do you want me to do, start sending orchids?
Hey, come on, let's take a walk, huh?
I'd rather go over the house.
Oh, you're kidding. Why?
Oh, just to take a look.
Oh, expect to find a million tucked away in an old pillowcase?
You never can tell, boy. Come on, just to satisfy my curiosity. Okay, I satisfied my curiosity. Ted knew the old place backward and forward. Almost all of the furniture had been cleared out. And if there was a hiding place for anything, we'd have found it. But it still bothered me, and it bothered me after I finally went to bed. Then, in the middle of the night, somebody was taking a walk in the house. I got out of bed, opened my door, then went to Ted's room. Ted. Ted, wake up.
Huh? Huh? What's the matter? Oh, Dan.
Be quiet.
What's the matter with you? You walking in your sleep?
I heard someone upstairs.
Oh, large mice. Go back to bed.
I tell you, I heard someone walking around. What's directly above my room?
Your room?
Yeah.
Why, this is that old room I played in when I was a kid.
What's in there?
Oh, cut it out, will you, Dan?
What's in that room?
Nothing. You saw it. A trunk with some old toys in it, that's all.
I heard someone walking around up there.
Ah, you were dreaming. You've got your head so crammed
full.
That's
a car.
Huh? Yeah, so what?
But you and I are the only ones in the house.
That's what I said.
But someone just drove away from here.
That car was on the road, not on the grounds here.
Drove away from here.
All right, it drove away from here. Now go back to sleep. The next dream you have, tell Freud, not me.
I knew I'd heard someone upstairs. Somebody was going through that old room which Ted had used as a playroom when he was a kid. But why? Ted and I had gone through it with a fine-tooth comb, and there was nothing there. But the next morning, I wanted a better look, so Ted and I went back.
I don't know why I'm doing this except to humor you, Dan. There's nothing in this room.
Hey, how old is that horn?
I don't know. Maybe 20 years. Oh, get this. Uncle Thaddeus never threw away a thing.
Not even his money.
Oh, still harping on that, huh?
Yeah. Hey, what else is in that trunk?
Oh, baseball glove, dust, ball, bat. Gosh, this rabbit's almost as old as I am. Then, let's see, tops, strings, that's all.
And there's nothing else in the room?
Nope.
Yet someone was up here last night looking for something.
Oh, Dan, stop it.
What's the matter?
Nothing. Nothing, I guess.
Come on. What were you going to say?
Wait a minute.
Lose something?
I don't know.
Why don't you know? Seems to me there's...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.